The Wendy Williams Show premieres September 16th. Wendy is here when she brought along Norman Baker, her Hot Topics senior producer. Is there any story you won't do in Hot Topics?
Any story we won't do? No, everybody's fair. Everybody's business is our business.
Now, let me ask you this. When you were going, we talked about this a little bit on Radio Andy a couple weeks ago. When you were going through your stuff publicly, were you
still going through it?
Were you staying away from infidelity stories because you felt like, okay, well, if I'm not talking about this, I can't talk about other people?
No.
You were not?
No.
Okay. Let's go to Justin from Atlanta. Hey, Justin, what's your question?
Hey, Andy. By the way, I love the facial hair. You look like a total daddy.
Thanks. Well, I am a daddy, so. No, I mean, I am.
Hi, Wendy.
Hi, Justin.
You're fabulous.
Thank you, Justin.
My question is, how do you feel about Lisa Vanderpump leaving Beverly Hills?
Who? The thing is that I love Lisa Vanderpump, but these housewives, like, people don't understand. Me, you, everybody is replaceable. And I think that Camille Grammer has come in and put the hammer down. I think that Lisa Renner is a formidable opponent. Lisa Vanderpump, I don't care.
All right, let's go to Elijah from New Jersey. Hey, Elijah, what's your question?
Hey, Andy. Hey, Wendy. How you doing?
How you doing?
Hey, Wendy, my question for you is, what is the one thing that you found out about yourself that you didn't know while you were in your marriage?
Something you found out about yourself in the last few months.
That I am more fearless than I thought. Like, honestly, more like, it's me against the world to take care of my son. And myself.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm fearless. Come one, come all to my Halloween ball.
Did you just make that up or is that a saying?
No, I've said it several times.
Yeah. I love it. Jeremy from Chicago. Hey, Jeremy, what's your question?
Oh my God. Okay. Hi, Wendy. I love you so much. You totally are my idol. I would love to find out who has been your favorite and least favorite guest on your show, as well as do you think you'll ever unite or link up with Mariah Carey? You guys are so similar to me.
Oh, wow. We just asked that. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, it's not, I don't like Mariah. I'm a lamb. I mean, not as lambish as Norman, whose office is plastered with all Mariah. I like Mariah. So, yeah, you know, I mean, she had like a Wendy interview. I will.
Yeah, she quoted you.
Yeah, no, I
mean,
like
her.
She
called you out.
And I don't have a favorite guest. I do have to say, though, that having my mother and father participate in the audience and be around the show has been a big deal because I didn't grow up as the one who would be the big deal.
Right.
It was just
that was Wanda.
But Wanda's the oldest, though, and she's a big deal. But I was just kind of the one, like, you know, I was fat and tall and awkward and, you know, all talking too much and weird, I guess. So the idea of my parents coming on my actual show and seeing me succeed, they are my favorite guests from
That's
the heart.
That's nice.
Yeah.
No, what about any least favorite guest?
Well, I can't say that, but I do have a least favorite guest, and they usually...
Omarosa?
No. I wasn't even thinking of her. He happens to be a man.
Oh, the least favorite guest is a man. Okay. Okay.
Stop thinking.
Why, you think I'm gonna get it?
No, you won't.
Okay, let's go to Chris from Orlando. Hey, Chris, what's your question for Wendy Williams?
Oh my God, what a pleasure. This is truly an early birthday present to speak to both of you. Quickly, Andy, I just want to say thank you for the many years of Watch What Happens Live. It's been a blessing.
Thank you very much.
And to see your to see your son, it's just an inspiration to me, and I can't say enough about you. But to the incomparable Miss Wendy Joan Williams.
Yes. Wendy Joan.
How dare you know me so much?
No, ma'am. I am not a stalker. You've never met me or talked to me until now. Okay. But I just want to say, for someone that lives their life in the public, with so many people saying this and that, only you know the true story, and you keep that internally, and you never share that with us. But you give us everything that you want to give us, and always remember that. But here's my question.
Okay.
God, I can't believe I'm talking to you. out of all the interviews you've ever done, the one that you were not looking forward to, what would you say turned out to be one of the better ones? So the ones that you were like, oh, I got to interview this person.
Right.
After it, who was one of the best ones you ever had? Thank you for talking to me once.
Aw, thanks, Chris.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you, Chris.
That happens to me all the time where I go into an interview and I'm like, oh, whatever.
It happens to me a lot. You know,
and then you're like, I like that person.
You know, I'll be honest with you, Chris. Thank you for the question. It happens a lot. You know, my favorite shows of The Wendy Show in all these 11 seasons is just me and you. I love my co-host. And the ones watching on TV as well as the ones in the studio. I love all Hot Topics, Inside Scoop. Ask Wendy has gotten more juicy than ever. I love to do the cooking segments because now you all understand I'm a foodie, but if I don't like it, I'm gonna tell you I don't like it. But I must say, it happens to me a lot. Like, okay, who's coming on the show? All right, let's go. And then after the show, or while I'm talking to the person, I'm like, oh my gosh. I really like this person.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. And now that I'm single, let's change numbers. Like, let's have lunch afterwards. Yeah.
Yeah.
It happens a lot though, Chris. Thank you so much. There's not one particular person. It happens a lot.
Natalie Ale on Twitter said, is it true you once hooked up with the Notorious B.I.G? Lil Kim said that you did.
Okay, that will play out in my Lifetime movie, okay?
All right. KDM, I think I know the answer to this. KDM texted, is it true that Cosby once tried to get you fired from the radio?
Absolutely.
Yeah, he did.
Well, it was back in the early 90s when, you know, I wasn't even the main person in a three-people morning show with news and everything. So, like, five of us.
Yeah.
But I was the gossip girl, and I had talked about Cosby and some of the ways that he had in his life at that particular time, and that was back
stuff that we now learned about.
That was
years
back
later.
In like 1991. Uh-huh. Okay,
when he had the power and he was still doing it.
1991.
Yeah.
And here
yeah.
I am dishing the dirt. For those of you who listen to 98.7 Kiss back in the day, I'm dishing the dirt. He called my general manager. The general manager sided with Cosby, but I was making ratings with the morning show, so I didn't get fired. But I got called into the office on a three-way conference call. It was me, the general manager, and Cosby, and he's dressing me down. And then the GM sends me out of the office, and I go back to, you know, doing my thing. But I'm crying through the hall, but I dab my tears, and I'm like, okay, all right now. Well, wow. Bill Cosby just dressed me down, and I'm only a few years old. So in my way, it was a way of being acknowledged by somebody. Like, really? Of all the things in Dr. Cosby's life, Norman, that affect him, it's calling little old Wendy.
Right.
Not even the main character on a morning show at Kiss.
Right.
So, and all these years later, look at little old Wendy and look at Cosby.
I want to thank Wendy Williams, season 11 of the Wendy Williams Show, premiere September 16th. Thank you, Norman. Thank you, Wendy. It was awesome. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Watch more clips here and subscribe to our channel here. See ya.